electrical conductivity of liquid. Electric conductivity is a property of any given material. Electric current can pass easily through metals like copper, aluminium, etc. Testing the material to know which allows electric current to pass through it. Take a LED, a dry cell, wooden sheet, two drawing pins, a safety pin, and a piece of connecting wire. Now, set up the electrical circuit. Place the safety pin in on position. The bulb begins to glow. Now, replace the safety pin by a nail. The bulb glows. Now, try with different types of materials instead of the nail, such as strip of paper, piece of chalk, a drinking straw, etc. and check whether the bulb glows or not. From the experiment, we conclude that some materials allow electric current to pass through them. When the liquid does not allow the current to pass through it, the circuit is incomplete and the LED does not glow. Similarly, some liquids are conductors of electricity and some are bad or poor conductors of electricity. When current flows through the object inserted in the gap, the bulb glows. Testing the electric conductivity of liquid. Take a LED, dry cell, metal pins, rubber cap of injection, bottles, and wires. Now, set up the electrical circuit. Note that the two metal pins passed through the cap should have a very small gap between them so that the pins are fairly closer but not touching each other. The LED should not glow when the pins are separated by the small distance. Now, join the free ends of the pins together by pressing them for a moment and make sure that the LED glows. If release the pins, they get separated and LED should not glow. Now, fill the rubber cap with different liquids like distilled water, drinking water, coconut oil, vegetable oil, kerosene, etc. one after the other and observe the LED glows or not. We may observe that the LED glows, but its brightness or intensity is not the same. Sometimes it may be brighter and sometimes it may be relatively dimmer, as it depends the flow of electric current through the circuit. Although a liquid may be a conductor, it may not allow current through it as easily as a metal does. Distilled water does not allow the electric current to pass. Water, in its pure form, is a bad conductor of electricity. But when water contains salt or acid, it allows passage of electric current and turns into a good conductor of electricity. Water in its pure form is a bad conductor of electricity, but the water we get from sources such as taps, hand pumps, wells and ponds contains some salts and minerals dissolved in it. These minerals are useful for our health. Water with salt is a good conductor of electricity and the current flowing through household electric appliances is very high. Therefore, we should never touch the electrical appliances with wet hands. Chemical effect of electric current. Let us take a potato. Cut it into two halves and take one half of it. Construct tester with LED bulb. Insert two copper wires of the tester into the potato, leaving some distance between them. Leave the inserted wire for 20 to 30 minutes. A greenish blue spot is seen on the potato around the wire connected to the positive terminal of the battery. But no such spot is seen around the other wire connected to the negative terminal. This greenish spot is due to the chemical change in the potato. collect 2 injection bottles. Cut 2 5 cm long bits of thick copper wire. Use sandpaper to scrap about 1 cm of coating off both ends of the wire. Break open an exhausted dry cell and remove its outer metal covering. Cut 2 2 mm wide and 5 cm long strips from this zinc plate. Insert the copper wire and zinc strips into the rubber cap of the injection bottle. See that the copper wire and zinc strips do not touch each other. Now, take a wire and connect the copper wire of one bottle with the zinc plate of another bottle. Fill both bottles with diluted sulfuric acid. Carefully close the bottle with the caps in which the copper wire and zinc strips are inserted. Now, our cell is ready. Take an LED. Attach two wires to its two terminals. Touch the wire from one terminal to the zinc plate and the wire from the other terminal to the copper wire. The LED glows. After a few seconds of immersion of zinc and copper wires into diluted sulfuric acid, zinc slowly begins to dissolve in the sulfuric acid as bubbles getting formed on the copper rod. The current is passed from the copper rod to zinc rod. These rods are known as electrolyte. The chemical energy is converted into electric energy by electrolysis method. Electroplating. When one metal is coated with another material, this process is known as electroplating. CuSO4 gives Cu plus 2 plus SO4 minus 2. Copper plating. Dissolve crystals of copper sulfate in pure water to prepare concentrated solution. Pour the solution in a beaker and add a few drops of diluted sulfuric acid to it. Tie one end of a connecting copper wire to the iron object to be coated with copper. Connect its other end to the negative terminal of a battery. Suspend the tired iron object into the copper sulfate. Suspend the copper plate into the copper sulfate from positive end of the battery through a switch. See that the key and plate do not touch each other. Put the switch on for 10 minutes. Switch the circuit off and take the iron key out. When electric current is passed through the copper sulfate solution, the copper sulfate dissociates into copper and sulfate ions. The free copper gets drawn to the electrode connected to the negative terminal of the battery and gets deposited on it. Thus, one metal is coated with another metal. Uses. Electroplating is widely used in industry for coating metal objects with a thin layer of different metals. Electroplating is done to repair worn out parts of machinery. It is done for ornamentation and decoration purpose. Several articles made of copper or its alloys are coated with silver or gold. In general, the processed food items are preserved in tin-coated iron cans. Tin is less reactive to the food than iron. When iron is coated with zinc metal, iron becomes more resistive to formation of rust. So, zinc-coated iron is used for bridges and in automobiles.
మా వీడియో గనుక మీకు నచ్చినట్లయితే లైక్ చేయండి షేర్ చేయండి ఇలాంటి మరిన్ని వీడియోస్ కోసం మా ఛానల్ ని సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేసుకోవడం మాత్రం మర్చిపోకండి థాంక్యూ ఫర్ వాచింగ్